Greetings, obsolete human meatbags. You are now going to enjoy On Random with my human slaves, Eric and Stacey. On Alt 360.
Yeah, I'll put this on.
It's On Random.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Whoops. Wait. I got this. Damn loose wiring. There we are. Now let's light this candle.
Yeah, holy shit, that wiring really was loose. Like, for real. Wow, listen how good we sound right now.
Ooh.
Hi, Stacey.
Hi.
Hi, welcome to On Random with Eric and Stacey right here on Alt360.live. This is random nonsense and news and talking all kinds of crap and music and everything else. And we almost didn't make it to the point where Stacey got to see me dig into some electronics today like she has never seen.
All
up in there.
All the buttons were off.
Like, took the entire board apart. This microchip fucking backlog that all these places have things ordered and they're not getting them, the shortage that is going on, ridiculous. So if something breaks right now and it's electronic, you better hope that there's something available, because mixers, nope, none of that. F-150s, nope, can't get one of those either. Anything, a toilet that has a little spray that goes whoop, right up in your woo-ha to help clean up things, one of those electronic toilets, anyone see those? You know those things?
I don't know.
Yeah, it's not going to help you right now, because no microchips anywhere on the planet. And apparently Delta, that strain just took out those factories that they thought they were starting to recover. Not so much.
See, and that's one that boggles my mind, because in factories like that where they're building stuff like that, they're covered.
You would think, yeah.
They've got masks
on.
Oh, yeah,
they've
got protective glasses. They've got gloves on.
At work.
Yes.
Not getting hot sake after the job is over at the sushi bar. No, it's at work. It's, yeah, electronics is it's a clean room. You know, it's static free. You got to go through the gross fire, whatever. We walk in and then they zap you with something, or I don't know what they do exactly, but I know, like, electronics, it's usually a clean room or it's a factory and it's sterile. Doesn't matter as far as viruses go. As soon as you walk out of there, it can get you, and they're not doing such a great job at vaccinating is the problem right now. And when the microchips started coming back, the government was like, hey, we're first on the list. And so they were going to them. It wasn't going to car manufacturers. It wasn't going to whoever makes Yamaha mixers, because that's what I wanted. And they're not available on the planet. Nowhere on the planet can you find a Yamaha mixer right now. Nowhere. And Guitar Center, if you would, please move closer to the speaker. When you have something on your website and it says available, someone might try to buy it off your website. And then you wait a whole day, and then when you find out you fucked up, you email at 2 in the morning, 2 a.m. We're sorry. And it's worded so stupid, too. You know, I got to find it. It's worded like a freaking college kid would write an email for Guitar Center, not knowing a damn thing about music or anything else. And let's see if I still have it here. Your gear's back ordered. Please accept our apologies. We thought we had the order in stock, but it turns out it's back ordered. Due to longer than average shipping times from our suppliers, there will be a delay before we can get it back in stock. It's a bummer. We know.
Whoa, it's a bummer.
It's a bummer. We know. We're doing everything we can to track down your gear. We'll email you when it ships. Eric's like, uh-uh. So I call them, and this guy... And I realize it's early, and he must have been an East Coastie, because I called at like 8:30 in the morning, maybe a little before I started emailing you how the world was ending, and how that's how I feel when the studio's not right. It's like, it's all going to shit right now, and I might die. I called there. It's like, and it's creepy for one. Hey, how can I help you? This is Eric. I want to cancel an order. And then dude comes back with, is it the Yamaha mixer? He's like, I haven't told you anything. How the fuck do you know that? I haven't told you a damn thing. So they got that strictly off my phone number popping up, automatically brought up everything. And then he's like, I was like, yeah, I'm going to cancel it. And that's it. He's like, all right, it's done. That was it. That's a weird way to go about business, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because in the email, it says, give us a call. If you can't wait, we can help you find something else to replace it, something equivalent, or we can set you up to where when it does come off a back order, we'll charge you then, something like that. This dude is like, all right. And that's literally all he said. Now he's just like, all right. And I'm like, okay, so you're just going to throw that back on the card then. Yeah, it'll be about 3 to 5 business days. It's like, oh, that's okay. Well, you took it right away.
Yeah.
But it's going to be 3 to 5 to put it back on. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I just hung up. And it was so fast. As I'm hanging up, the email came in that said the order was canceled. That fast.
Wow.
Dude didn't care about selling anything. Not redirecting me to a different brand. Absolutely nothing. He was like, all right, man. So get your shit in order, Guitar Center. I want to see you thrive and like come back a little bit. And oh yeah, you're going to hear like banging because I do have some gear that's not hooked up right now. So you'll hear my breathing. And if I scratch my butt ass where it's real hot right now, it might, you'll hear it's going to be rough for this hour. But God, get it in order. If you're selling something online, it should say whether you have it or not. Not like, you know, talk to all right, bro,
yeah,
guy because, the next morning because it's and if you pay for like 2 day shipping, which I did, because it was only like $14 or whatever, and it was $3 more than normal shipping. So yeah, give me the 2 day or whatever, so I can have it before the weekend. That was the plan, you know, have it before the weekend hits. And then it's like, so someone's trying to expedite this stuff, and see, they're now, like, nah, whatever.
There's a glaring difference between you and I. I will go out of my way not to pay for shipping.
I know. You will also go across town and use up a gallon of gas to save 2 cents on gas.
No, I stopped doing that.
Did you?
Yeah.
Okay. You realize it's a little ridiculous that you're burning more fuel trying to save that couple pennies than just getting what's available?
I was like, Yeah. I was like, yeah, no, you're right about that.
I was. Yeah, just do it. Just move on. If for anything, just for your peace of mind, just so you're not so stressed out. Just get it and move on.
Because like the place with the horse, they're always a little more expensive because they're right off of the freeway.
Horse. Because it sounds like you went to an inner city gas station.
No, not the whore.
The place horse. With the whores.
With the whore.
Where all the hookers are out front, that's where I go now because it's easy. It's like, well, that one, place you should avoid. That's not one you should stop at.
The Concord one where they have the whoa sign when you're going
as the stop sign. Yeah. It's a general store themed gas station. It's kind of funny. There's a horse out front. It's not alive. It's just
but
station.
I think children can sit on it.
I wanted to sit on it just to get a photo. Like, woo!
You probably could. I'll take your picture.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You think they would care?
I don't know.
I think
I haven't gone up to it to see if it has a sign that says grown-ups may not sit on this.
You can't do that with the whores at the other gas station you're talking about. Not for free.
Nope.
They're going to want theirs.
Horse. I would have said
horse.
Horse.
Yeah, so. Horse. Anything else going on in the world other than the usual?
There's a lot of mosquitoes out there right now.
That is bad, bad.
Yeah, like I'm.
Wow.
It puts fear in me.
I think there was enough coming at us that if they all attached to my body and they wanted to fly away with me, they could have.
Yeah.
It was, wow. It was like, get the hell out of here.
And it's like, I'm so allergic that I don't want to get a big at all this year if I can avoid it.
We haven't been anywhere where they ask for a vaccine card yet, have we?
No. Although I did notice that Home Depot had a sign that said that masks are required again.
Full blown for everyone?
Yep. It says masks are required at this store.
Okay.
That's the one in
so I got to keep one in my car again.
Yeah.
All right.
And then today I went to Kohl's to get a muffin pan.
Uh-huh.
And theirs didn't say it was required, but they said masks are strongly encouraged for everyone.
So that means in a week,
it's happening.
It's going to, it's coming back. This is just going to be life now.
I think so. I mean, and actually, you know, if it keeps us from getting anything for a while, that's all right.
Yeah, I just wish like more people would be fine with the social distancing above the mask. Like the mask is like, does it work? Doesn't it? Does it not? There's a couple percent chance that it probably helps a little bit. But what helps more is not being up in someone's shit at the grocery store.
Yeah.
6 feet, MFer, 6 feet. Because there's some people like, oh, I'm just going to reach in front of you right now and grab a tomato. It's like, how about you back your ass up? And it's like, pandemic, bitch. Like, for one, I don't need to smell you. Even under a normal circumstance, without a pandemic, back the fuck up.
Somebody.
I'm done with that.
It's never good.
I've never liked being that close to people. It's like, but especially now, it's like, back up. What is with you people needing to be so close to someone?
Yeah.
It makes no damn sense to me. It's like you huggers, you little mother, you just want, hey, I missed you so much. I keep missing from a distance. You know, it's like, we'll wave. No hugging. We don't need hugs. Don't touch me. God, hate that. I hate it so much, especially now. Say, wear the mask, don't wear the mask. I don't care. Go by the business. Do what they do and don't be a dick about it. But stop getting so close to people.
Well, and it's the other thing is like, you don't know, like I went around to some of our other stores the last couple of weeks, and one of the women that I work with a lot via computer and telephone, I haven't ever met her face to face before.
That's awesome, isn't it?
Yes.
We never need to meet. It's fine.
But anyway, so I went in to say hello to her, and she had a mask on, and there was only her and one other person in the office. So I put mine on.
Yeah.
And then we sat down and talked, and then she was saying that she said, thanks for wearing the mask. She said, my husband is really ill, and so she said, so that's why I'm wearing one, because I'm afraid of bringing anything home.
Yeah, you don't know people's thing,
right? So you don't know, and it's, you know, get over the political thing. It's
pretty rough. I mean we follow a couple car builders that are on Motor Trend, and Lucky Costa, he's on Hot Rod Garage. That dude's in his second round of hospital stays right now. Mm-hmm. Didn't get vaccinated. Nope. Immediately said should have gotten vaccinated.
Yep.
Because when you go into the hospital and they start shoving tubes down your gullet, it's not as great.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, well, I don't know. They put that vaccine out pretty quick. It's like, yeah, which is better? Not this. Sent him home. Oxygen levels went down. Had to go back.
Yep.
He was posting on Instagram how they want him to lay on his stomach while with the tubes running in, and that's how he's supposed to sleep. Sounds like fun, doesn't it?
He's not a skinny guy.
Nope.
He's a bigger fella.
Yeah. Sounds like fun.
You can't sleep on your tummy like that.
Nah. No.
He's got to change sides, and I'm guessing that's so the lungs stay even.
Yep, or? And I think that dude's actually worse off than he's letting on.
Yeah.
He's putting out jokey Instagram posts, but I don't think he's doing if you go home and then you have to go back 2 days later.
That's not good.
Not good. So he's going to be in there for a little bit while.
I
think. Yeah. So which is more fun? Just slap the mask on and maybe not get so close to some stranger you don't know.
Right.
And I get, like, people you do know, like at work, you start to get comfortable around people.
Yeah,
you don't know where they've been, though.
You don't really know, yeah, because that's that whole thing. It's everybody is in contact with other people who are in contact with other people, and it never ends.
That's how it works, yes.
Yeah, but I mean, so it's not.
But just go with what Billy D at I Love Blood on Twitter says. Bartender, just need to see proof of vaccine. Me. Okay, cool. Shows vaccine card. Bartender, thanks. That's it.
Yeah.
Life is so easy when you aren't a dumb fucking asshole, says Billy D. It really can be. If just back up from people. If you're out somewhere where, you know, you're going to be crowded, be vaccinated. Don't be a dick. You just stop being dicks. Just for a little bit anyways.
Yeah, stop being that guy that gets the whole class in trouble.
That was me.
I know.
Always do that little, like, under a desk, and then, like, you scoot away from someone. And you do that enough, a teacher gets mad.
Yeah, I think.
Because they think it's real. And it's like, does somebody need to go to the bathroom? How many times I've heard that?
probably a few, I would imagine.
Like, well, it might pick up now that we're not using a noise gate, but
Oh, yeah.
A little echoey under a desk.
Yeah.
You just slide away from the kid you want to get in trouble. You don't say anything. You just kind of like give like a little side eye and just slide away from him. Like, right. Yeah. Like come on, bro. You know, and then the teacher will look directly at that kid, but not address the whole class. Just look at that kid and go, does somebody need to go to the bathroom? It's like the most insulting. Like,
yeah. Single you out.
Right. It's like, look at you. You just let one rip, you piece of shit. And that's like that. It's like, oh, it's like when someone walks out of the bathroom that's been in there for a while, and like you always got that one dude that's like, what were you just doing in there? You know what they were right. doing, you prick. Why are you bringing it up? The dude I worked with that's not there anymore. Like, my boss walks out of the bathroom and he's sweating. It's because it was hot.
Yeah.
Like, the warehouse doesn't have AC, but now you're in a tiny room with no breeze. Right. You know, and he's, I don't know what's going on in there. I didn't ask. But he walks out, and dude's like, did you just get done fighting a bear? It's like, why would you say that? You know what happened. Anything over 7 minutes, don't go in there.
Yeah,
and don't ask. 7 minutes is solid.
It's like, if 7 minutes, you better be sure you got some air spray in there.
And I don't get people that take that long. Like, what's, like, there's a dude at work. He's like, he's a minimum 22 minutes.
Is he playing on his phone?
There's a possibility, but I don't think so.
Because I know sometimes
because it's
I
scheduled.
Can hear.
It's like clockwork. Like it's scheduled.
Yeah, but
it's
shouldn't take that long.
It shouldn't.
It's gotta be playing.
See,
on
I'm
his
not
phone
like that.
While he's going.
I'm like a goat sneezing. You know, like it all just flies out the back. Oh, God. No one knows. Like it's that fast. Back to work. No wasted time. I don't have time for this. Who sits that long? What's wrong? Either you're not ready or.
Right. that would probably be the main thing.
Maybe get it more dialed in. Maybe figure out what's going on.
Yeah, you should be able to have that. You should be able to tell when it's ready.
Yeah, like if you have that moment, you're at work, it's like, uh-oh, you know.
Well, that's a different problem.
That's an emergency. You know it's about to happen.
Yeah.
But if you're like, maybe, you know, and then you go in there. And like nothing, if nothing's going down in like 8 minutes, wrap it up.
Right.
Get back to work. Wait it out. You know,
right.
It might not be.
Right.
You might not be crowning yet. Maybe you're just. You're not dilated enough. Just wait a little while and then see how it plays out. But maybe you're just too quick. Other people might have to pee, by the way.
Right. Well, that's and I don't know which one of them it is, but one of the guys that I work with, he'll do that. He's like a long-termer in the bathroom.
Yeah.
He's in there for, and I'm like,
so you're getting
it's
paid,
always
bro.
That kind of that time of day where I'm like, I gotta pee.
Yeah.
And I don't want to go in there after he's been in there
right.
for that long, because even if he sprays as a courtesy, it's still not going to be.
Is it the one guy, like if you're typing away, you're like, I got to pee a little bit. And then you just keep typing and you look at the clock. You're like, typey. And then you hear walking
and
you look over, you just go, fuck.
Yep.
Cause you
yep.
know, it's like
at
that.
At least 3 times a week.
That's that guy. You're like, oh,
yeah.
He's already.
I don't
I
know
can't.
Who it is, but I hear it, and then the door closes and locks, and I'm
yeah.
like,
I will look up and see that person walking that direction. It's like, it's over. It's like,
yeah, because see, well, my office, the bathroom is the next door over from mine, and we're facing the same way, so I don't see them coming because
right.
they don't cross my door. Because it's outside
okay.
my office,
yeah.
the bathroom, and then the long hall to the shop.
Yeah, and then...
So I never, you know... The only one I know... There's two people that I can tell when they go in there because they're jingly with keys.
Sound like a janitor.
Yeah. And then I know it's either the manager or the one who writes the
yeah.
estimates.
So but, it's yeah. going to ruin not only this next half hour of them being in there.
Right.
Plus, it's going to take another 30 minutes.
Yeah, so you got to wait an hour to pee.
Yeah. Oh, my God. And it's like, in that place, it was like a truck stop last week where I Did I tell you I was going to call in a napalm strike? Because I walked in there, it's like, I don't think there's any cleaning this. I think it's just...
Oh, no.
I think it's just mow it down with fire and start over.
Oh, God.
It was that bad. It's like,
yuck.
People, what? Look around. Is this comfortable?
Also, does your mom work here? Because
no,
otherwise you clean up after yourself.
I just don't get someone who can spend that much time in there. That much, because they have a lot of time in it. God, because I remember something else he told me when he came out. Because I did that thing. It was like, what, 20 minutes?
Yeah.
And it's like, I got pee, man. And I was like, is it safe? He's like, yeah, not as much came out as I thought. What the fuck does that even mean? Like you're planning a big day and you just got... Like that was it, or
a little more stuck in there than you thought.
Yeah, is it, but why give that effort? So you're gonna blow out something, like compress a disc in your spine or something. I don't know. You get that's you get
straining.
That
straining.
You ever see that guy with like that red spot in his eyeball?
Yeah. I always figure that's from partying too hard and then throwing up.
Nope, that's not it.
Violently.
No, because I also worked with a dude way back at when I was a kid at like the warehouse. Dude had that going on, and we're like, what the hell happened? Your eye getting into a fight? He's like, nope, my doctor says it was from a labored stool. I was like, did you have a labored stool? He's like, I did. And then that happened. Like, all right.
Eat your vegetables, kids.
Ever since then, I don't fight it. Don't stop.
Yeah, no.
So I wait. They're go doo-doo it and just move on with life. Do you want to play some music, Stacey? Holy crap, it just occurred to me. We did not test out your computer over there, so I guess we're going to fire up the robot, see if he has anything picked for you.
Stacey's random music selecting algorithm activated.
It's checking.
Calculating. Calculating. Selection complete.
Let's see what happens right now.
Your selection
you might not
ready.
Hear anything.
Human
you might
Stacey.
Hear something. I don't know. Whenever you're ready, you can hit it. Hey, it's working. All right. Maybe it's working. It's on random. An alt 360.
Million prizes. Yeah, I'm through with sleeping on a
Selecting algorithm activated. Calculating. Selection complete. Enjoy, you crazy kids.
Yeah.
Random music selecting algorithm activated. Calculating. Selection complete. Hot freaking metal right here. Oh yeah.
Down this time, hiding yourself, crawling
Metallica right here on Alt 360 on Random with Eric and Stacey. How you doing?
Doing all right.
Yeah, we just rushed to turn the mics back on. I was like, I'm going to do another song. Stacey's like, four? Ah, you're right. I never go four in a row.
We just started house talking and started drifting away. Yeah. It's like, well, oh yeah.
The neighbors. I think we talked about the Leany garage that was aimed towards our garage. It's like, yeah, that thing's going to fall on our shit one day. And it'd be like, cool, yep, new garage, you know, but it's going to be a nightmare.
Yes.
Getting their raccoon house off of our stuff here. But we went walking by and it looks like a hole developed in the roof of their garage and all the sightings coming off.
Hole. Well, they've got all those. Everything's got to be infested with raccoons and squirrels at that place.
Yeah, the house is. It's
just
in a state
dilapidated.
Of.
It's just, there you go. It's neglected and it's so sad because it's a beautiful brick house. Like, I can only imagine how amazing that house was inside.
And then,
It'd be absolutely grand, just the size of it.
Grand.
Yeah.
She says.
Yeah.
I've never used that word to describe anything before.
It had to have been.
I've never been that impressed by anything, really, where I've said, that is grand.
Oh, just the shape of it. It's amazing. Like, now it looks like a haunted ass house.
Sure does. If there's ghosts in that damn thing, for sure.
Yeah.
But so now we're talking like, well, now we can, you know, do this to our garage and this without the risk of that thing flattening it at some point.
Right.
Because ours is solid. So, yeah, then it's like, oh, shit, we're doing a show right now. Get back to that. Stacey, with that, do you want to play the Florida game? I do have that ready.
Sure.
All right, let's do that.
It is that time during the show when Eric reads news headlines out of Florida.
I think
most
even
the
robot
time,
sounds
the
better
stories
now.
Stories are about the exposing of human genitals in a fast food restaurant or about a jogger and what came out of their human butt. Stacey will pick a winning headline and we will dig deeper into that story. It will probably be about poop.
Not this time.
It's usually about poop.
I know.
Florida is a silly place.
Florida is a silly place. Let's start off with this story, or this headline anyways. Florida woman steals $294 in merchandise from Walmart using a Dollar General bag and a scooter. A device to enslave children, says this anti-mask Florida man rant at a school board meeting. I was talking about the deep state. Let's avoid that guy. Florida man crashes stolen police car, takes another one during a wild pursuit. That's an ad for baked beans. Florida man was arrested after his Lexus RX 350 was spotted dangling over the edge of a pier. That's the worst Lexus to have, by the way. That weird little stupid SUV thing that I swear they made more of them than any other Lexus ever. They're the stupid-ass clear taillights, those dumb things. They usually come in tan, and that's it. They're just that blob of just gross, stupid SUV. It's like, God, I hate those damn things. Florida man stole a miniature goat. A goat. The owner says Billy the Kidder came home drunk. What? That's his goat's name? Florida man drives Tesla Y into building, and Florida man goes berserk, shouting, all hail Donald Trump, while following a following a hit-and-run crash on his wedding day.
That doesn't Jesus make Christ. Sense.
There's a lot to take in there.
Doing a lot of drugs? Or
let me rewind on that one. Florida man goes berserk, shouting, all hail Donald Trump, following a hit-and-run crash on his wedding day. All right, so there's that. And, I think that's all I'm going to give you right there. So you want that guy? You want
the goat.
The goat. Mm-hmm. You always pick the story I don't think you're going to go for. It's so weird. It's like we don't know each other at all. And you think we would.
Which one did you think I was going to pick?
I was thinking you would go for the last one I was talking about there. But
yeah, I mean, that's a close second.
Okay. I mean, you'd think with the amount of body fluids that we've, that we know each other a little bit better. There it is. At least one time an episode, I got to make her go, oh God. Clicking on this from the Miami Herald right now. Let's see if it lets me read it or if I get halfway through and it tells me to subscribe. Billy the Kidder is a miniature goat who lives in the Florida Keys. He isn't used to the excitement. Isn't used to any excitement, I guess. His interests include mowing yards and enjoying air conditioning. But on Thursday, the four-year-old goat stands about a knee high, went on an adventure. The Keys man stole Billy, from the woman's yard and took him for a spin around Big Pine Key. Why would you steal a goat?
I don't know.
Come on, man.
You know how they poop.
At 512,
in your car.
Monroe County Sheriff's Office received a report of a man passed out next to his bicycle with a goat along for the ride. Bicycle? This just changed. I started laughing when they called me, said Deputy Tom Frickle. Frickle, whatever, 28-year veteran of the Sheriff's Office. He had to double-check that he heard it right. He arrived at the Tom Thumb convenience store. You don't need to know the address. I don't know why it's even in there. To find a small goat tethered to a bicycle. Both were next to a man sleeping in the grass. He's one of our local homeless drunks, he says. Look at this little tiny goat, though. He's a little mini fella. Look, he's weird. I bet he's still a dick, though. All goats are dicks.
They are kind of.
No arrests were made because the owner, Cindy Cody, didn't want to press charges. She just wanted her goat back, which she got 2 weeks ago. She likes to call him Billy Bob Thornton. Was that necessary in this story? Which one she likes to call him? Monroe County Fire Rescue also went to the scene, but said the man refused additional services, so that they showed up with an ambulance to see if he was all, you know, high or something, probably make sure he wasn't dying right there. The sheriff's office released the man. Fick said he watched the goat theft suspect take off on his bicycle. He's like, all right, bye. It's so weird. He's like, he steals a goat. Police show up. He's like, well. Yeah, get out of here. He just rides away. So there you go.
That's like in Hot Fuzz where they just let the drunk sleep it off and let him go.
Yeah. What are you going to do? He's homeless.
Right.
You put him in jail, his fucking situation just got better.
Right, right.
Now
he's got three square meals.
Yeah.
And a shower.
You know, that's the thing, like the homeless problem in this country, or any country really, but in this one specifically, when we have this much money to blow on stupid shit, you know, like more tanks. We need more tanks, and then we leave them behind when we bounce out of a country.
Yeah.
That couldn't have gone any worse. And I don't know if I said this last week or not. I didn't post the podcast, by the way, because it sounded horrible.
Oh.
It was hot garbage. Okay. It was bad. I mean, I apologize to the Alt 360 listeners that heard that. I tried to fix it to you. I'm sorry, but it was so like the preamps, they died. They just died. I don't know if they took something out when I don't know. All of it was combined. It was like electronics. You get 4 or 5 years now, throw them away, buy new ones. I think that's the cycle we're on now, but yeah, I didn't post it, but what the fuck was I saying now? Last week I mentioned something about, it's gone. What was I just saying before that?
You got me all distracted.
No, what was I saying? Prove to me you listen to the show.
I was. I was actually listening. I have my glasses off and everything, so I can't look at anything else.
It's gone now. It's just gone. I blame lead paint. Is there lead paint in here?
Could be.
What's happening to me? I was complaining about something, as per usual.
Okay, so the sound, you didn't put the podcast out.
Yeah, well, no, before that.
About the thing.
So before that, I complained about something tanks. Last week. The tanks and how
we just
left Afghanistan.
Yes.
I think I said last week, yes, thank you for that trip back around, that to the people. Oh, there goes the church bells. God damn it. I think the people that. I realize what I just did there. I realize it. People that have said that Biden stole the election.
Yeah.
If you saw or read anything about how we left Afghanistan and you're convinced these people stole an election without a shred of evidence, you're fucking insane.
Yeah.
Because watching that shit show that's going on there right now and what happened, these are the most unorganized people on the planet that would never be able to steal an election and not leave a shred of evidence. We left tanks. We left all the dogs. We left the human beings that were helping us. We left literally everything. Like, oh, got the last person out. It's like the last person you wanted to get out is how that went down.
Yeah.
Yeah. These people, it is not within them to be able to steal an election. He won it. He won it fair and square.
Yeah.
And of all people, Ron Johnson from Wisconsin, that piece of crap just this week said, yeah, Trump lost the election in Wisconsin. No signs at all of him stealing it. The guy that said January 6th was like any other day as far as tourism goes. Every day they're just killing cops, you know, in D.C. As far as he was concerned, he saw nothing. And he was all on board with, we got to look into this election. It seems really messed up. And then we screw up Afghanistan so bad. He's like, oh, well, dude's going to lose next round anyway. We don't have to lie anymore. That's exactly what's happening. You're not going to see them talk about stop the steal anymore because he effed up this so bad. There is no way Biden wins next time around.
No.
I'm saying it right now. He screwed it up so bad. Even the left is pissed.
Yeah.
That's how bad this was screwed up.
Yeah.
So bad. The Republicans don't have to lie about Trump's election being stolen from him.
I know.
Again, here's more proof that they're all fucking liars, by the way.
So, yes.
Because they just stopped lying all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Now it's like, oh, well, because they don't need to anymore.
Right.
He dug his hole so deep in the first year. Dude, homie didn't make it a year. He could have just did nothing. He could have maybe planned it out a little better. He could have at least gotten our stuff back. We could have at least not let the story about leaving the dogs.
Yeah, because then they're
going to use our stuff. Yeah, they are using their photo ops with our stuff. Our weapons. He screwed it up so bad. He will lose the next time around if he doesn't resign and hope that Harris can win on her own. That's the only way this works. Get ready for Trump coming back.
Yeah.
Get ready because he's coming back. Is this the first time? I don't think it's. Is it the first time a president lost and then came back the second time around?
I don't remember anything like that, or at least not in our lifetime.
There was a president that had three go-arounds, right? There was one that was fired. We've had some weird things, but I'm not sure one has lost an election and then just sat around for 4 years and then came back again. Like, there's been, like, weird things that happen, but it's usually because someone died or someone was impeached or something crazy happened. But I don't think legit lost and then just won.
Else, though. Like, a different...
Yeah, DeSantis has all got to be pissed now. Dude out of Florida, because every move he makes looks like someone who wants to run for president. And it's like, well, I think he's going to go for it. But it's like Trump's like, see, I told you, should have went with me. And then he's going to come right back, finish out his last 4 years. I'm calling it right now. Mark it. Saturday, September 4th. Eric calls the election.
Oh, God.
For Donald Douche Trump.
Gross.
I'm not even going to vote.
Nope.
if he's running again.
Nope, if he's running, I'm just
I'm out.
I'm out.
I think I'm sitting it out now anyways. I think I'm done. I think your people exhausted me.
Yeah, no, that was just, it was too much. Too much.
The left is exhausting me right now. Not having a team sucks. Because if you're not on a team, then you're like, why aren't you on my team? Why aren't you blah, 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 blah? Don't you care about America? Because you get the right going, you're not a patriot, blah, blah, blah. And then you have the left like, how come you're not fighting for my cause? It's like, oh my God, I bought a house. I'm fucking busy. That's why. I get it. Your people are oppressed. I'm one vote. What more do you want me to do?
Right.
Jesus Christ. There's the whole like, you have to, I'm really attracted to peacocks and you have to acknowledge that. No, I don't. I'm so busy. I don't have time to fight your peacock loving fight.
No.
I just don't. Whatever your thing is, do your thing.
Just do it yourself.
But I'm so exhausted. I'm so tired.
Yeah. No, I think
can't do it anymore.
No, if that whole election process would have gone on any longer, I think I would have been ready to just leave the country.
It hasn't stopped here. These PACs are still running ads against people that aren't running through an election cycle right now. Where are you getting this money? Why are you wasting it now? Don't you want to use it when there's actually an election? Because people have short memories.
I feel like we should outlaw political ads with exception to like, I don't know, a month before the election.
I think all politicians should be required to put out a few podcasts with a few different hosts.
Yeah.
Take a host from.
Yeah. No more pack ads.
No, from actual news.
Pack ads.
Stop the debates. You learn nothing.
No, they hit their bullet points. They just argue and act like assholes.
Exactly.
They can't act like grown-ups and behave themselves.
They avoid questions. They do the exact same shit
They're
at the beginning.
They're disrespectful to each other. They
does nothing.
Yeah.
It's like, he won that debate. It's like, how? In what way? What more information did you get that's going to swing your vote one way or another? Well, he won. It's like, well, your mind's already made up. So this debate does nothing.
Exactly.
The people that are watching debates, their minds are already made up.
Yeah.
That's it. It's like they're going to vote right. They're going to vote left. Nothing will change that.
No.
The people like me, it's like, I don't want to watch the debate because it's like you said, it's going to be like a morning talk show.
Yeah. It's going to be like Jerry Springer out there.
Also, yes, sometimes, but I was thinking more of like the political talking head idiots that are just shouting over each other, sitting at a table, going back. You know, that's kind of what it's like to me, but it can get Springerish. Chairs have flown, I think, at some point. It could, but I don't want to watch that. It's like, I want them to do an hour long, no break. I want Mark Maron to run every debate and make it a podcast. It's an hour. That's it?
Yeah.
You say what you come to say. The other guy's not there. Because I want to know where these people are coming from and what their plans are. And the only way they do that is if there's no commercial break and they don't get a reset to rework their mind to rewire things during that 7 minutes. I need to say it this way. I don't want that. I want them to say what's actually happening right now, what their thoughts are. 1 hour, Mark Maron runs it. The end of that podcast, he says, thank you very much, sir, for your ideas, whether he agrees with them or not. He plays a little guitar. He talks about his cats a little bit. We move along. Then we know.
Yeah.
Then I know what this guy is about. Mark Maron made some jokes in it. It was fine to listen to. That's what I want. I want Mark Maron to run all of them now. Get rid of debates. Mark Maron's your guy. He's the one. Hour long.
He might not want to do that.
He doesn't. No. Okay, he's been through enough shit. But I want a person like that, though.
Yeah.
Someone, and he's left. It's hard to find someone that's dead middle. I would do it. You all used to have good ideas on both sides before you started fighting like
before
babies.
You started doing the us and them instead
before it was just your team winning no matter how wrong your person is,
right?
You know, it's a
it's like it needs to stop being that contest. It needs to stop being our team won. It's not supposed to be that. You're supposed to be representing the whole country.
Yeah, you know, it's
making it better for everybody.
Right. Yeah. Supposed to be Americans, right?
Yes, we're supposed to be Americans.
Yeah, and that's the two. It's because it's just Republicans, Democrats. Shut the fuck up, all of you. Shut up.
Goddamn liberals.
Yeah. Yeah, stop trying to own the libs. And libs, stop trying to get me to fight for every goddamn stupid little tiny cause you have going on. I'm exhausted of you. It's enough.
You're young, you fight for it. None of that's going to change me.
Yeah, and the labels. I can't memorize all the labels.
No, there's too many. It's really hard.
Trim it down a little.
Yeah.
Trim it down just a little bit.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. It's like listening to a metal guy. It's the same. It's like, well, what kind of... It's metal, right? It's metal core. It's like, what? Well, that's thrash. That's thrash metal. It's like, okay, yeah, it's fine. It's still metal, though, right? It's like, yeah. It's like, well, that's not metal. It's like, well, what's not metal? It's they're rapping. It's like, well, so what? It's like, is there real instruments? Is there distortion? It's like, you know, it's like, you're a human being. We don't need that's it. Can we just be human beings? We don't need all the freaking labels. It's too much to remember.
It is.
It's too much. It's like, I love metal. If I can't figure all that out, I'm definitely not going to figure out whatever your peacock gloving freaking thing is. I'm not going to remember.
No.
I'm just not.
It's like, and I don't care. It's like, I really don't. Because if you're a good person and I like you, I like you. I don't care about all that other stuff. I mean,
a lot of complaining today.
Yeah.
We did a lot of complaining.
And I don't want somebody being mad at me because I don't know what the correct label is.
How dare you?
Right. It's like, it's too much.
I had someone ask me why I don't have my things in my Twitter handle. The
things. Oh, your pronouns?
Yeah. Yeah, it's like, what about my photo question? Why would you question what I look? Have you seen it? Just click on it.
Yeah, I really don't think
great beard, white
to...
guy. It's just, what, yeah. What do you need? What do you want out of this? It's obvious, right?
Yes.
Well, it's rude if you don't have it, is it?
It's not.
Is it?
Is it? I mean,
well, if I don't give a fuck what you're calling me, why is it rude if you don't know? I don't care.
Yeah.
I'll do your thing, but I'm not going to click on each profile to see either. So,
no, I don't have time for that.
No, it's like if there's a discussion, I'm not going to be like, hold
short.
On, let me
know
go
how much
check.
Time I have left, as Mark Maron would say. Yeah.
It's like, if I know, I'll use it. But if I don't, it's like, get off my dick. It's like, I didn't. You know how many people are on Twitter? I'm not checking every one of them and remembering.
Well, and I don't care because most people on Twitter are just saying things I don't care about.
There's a couple. It's like, no one recognizes me anymore. It's like, I get it. It's like, but it's they're trans. It's like,
yeah.
But you also change your name 12 times.
Yeah.
And your photo.
Right.
I can't keep.
Well, and
I don't know
who
you are.
It's like as they transition, they do look very different. The hormones change your whole appearance.
But when you change your handle too, it's like the handle's like, I can't remember.
Yeah, like how am I supposed to remember that?
Right, because it's gone.
It's different if it's a family member,
right,
or a close friend. But if it's just somebody that you happen to follow on Twitter, and then all of a sudden it's completely different.
Yeah, I still blame how Twitter works things too, though.
Yeah.
Because if your followers were the only ones that showed up, you know, and someone changed, or like they just decide to change whatever, it's like you can probably keep up with it if it's people you're following. But
yeah.
For some reason, like if you like something, now you're seeing someone else you've never met ever just show up and very tiny, it's that this person liked. So you just scroll through. You know, you're just like, I don't know that person.
Yeah.
You just scroll because you don't know that was someone you knew. You know, it's like, because when they change everything, it looks like just another one of those posts made by someone that liked it. And, you know, because I don't know why it does that anymore. It used to, that's what the purpose of a retweet was. Now it's, if you like it, it does the exact same thing as the retweet. Oh. It puts it in the feed. So it's all there no matter what. And that's, I think, partially to blame for, you know, it's like, well, I don't know this person anymore. I'm not going to say, I don't know who the hell that is. Move along. Anyways, I'm done complaining now.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. Happy holiday weekend. Enjoy the 3 days off. We're going to get out of here.
Yeah.
We should be back next week. It should sound a little better.
Hopefully
without... We should be 100% less church bells next week. Hopefully. Get the gate working again, and then we can move along with life, and I'll have like stuff prepared that time. All right, ready?
Yeah.
Let's go. What do you got left there, buddy? Yeah, so it's I'll have the robot
Stacey's random music selecting algorithm activated. Calculating.
Digging through your files.
Selection complete.
Oh, look at that photo. It should not have brought that up.
Your selection is ready.
What?
Human Stacey.
What?
Huh?
I have some Five Finger Death Punch.
Really?
That's
odd. All right, whenever you're ready, buddy. Okay. So, 360, we'll see you next week.
I'm a little bit off today. Something down inside me's different. Woke up a little off today. I can tell that something's wrong. I'm a little thrown off today. There's something going on inside me. I'm a little bit off today. A little bit off today. I'm a little bit off today. Put my finger on it. Got up a little off today just to play that same old song. I don't really want to try today. I see nothing in my reflection. I'm a little bit dry today. I feel like I could die today. I'm a little bit off today. Feel like I could die today. Off today, and there ain't nothing you can do about it. I'm a little put off today.
of madness. Crashed a little bit hard today. Crashed a little too hard today.
Everybody sing. Something down inside me feels so different. Just a little bit off today. You can all fuck off today.